Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. A Travel with the Orient Express. Chapter 1. Departure into Luxury. The platform was alive with the clamor of excited voices and the shuffling of feet as passengers, dressed in their finest, awaited the arrival of the legendary Orient Express. The anticipation was palpable, a thick cloud of expectancy that filled the air. Then, with a hiss and a steely clatter, the train glided into the station, its polished locomotive reflecting the golden hues of the setting sun. It was a behemoth of elegance, an iron serpent adorned with the artistry of a bygone era. As the Orient Express whispered its way across the variegated European landscape, you were cocooned in a world of varnished woods, gleaming brass, and plush fabrics. The motion of the train was not just a physical lullaby, but a rhythmic reminder of an era that took pride in the art of travel. Your private compartment, a masterpiece of craftsmanship, was a snug sanctuary with polished and laid-wood panels, sumptuous seating that converted into a comfortable bed, and delicate lamps that cast a warm, golden glow. You couldn't help but be drawn to the window, where the scenery was a living canvas. Pastoral scenes with cows grazing languidly in fields, charming villages with smoke curling from chimneys, and distant mountains with peaks that seemed to pierce the very heavens, all flickered by. Each view was a fleeting masterpiece, replaced by the next with the relentless rhythm of the train on the tracks. Mealtimes were an event in themselves. The dining car, with its white linen-clad tables and heavy silverware, promised a culinary journey as memorable as the physical one. The waiters, in crisp uniforms, moved with a balletic grace, serving dishes that were as much a feast for the eyes as for the palate. Each course was a symphony of flavors, from the delicate amuse-bouche to the richness of a perfectly cooked chateaubriand, and finally to the decadence of a chocolate mousse that seemed to dissolve the moment it touched your tongue. The afternoons were for lounging in the bar car, where conversations flowed as freely as the drinks. The bartender, a maestro of mixology, crafted cocktails that seemed to capture the essence of the lands you traversed. You sipped a drink infused with herbs that smelled of the mountains and savored a liquor as dark and mysterious as the tunnels the train occasionally plunged into. As evening approached, the train seemed to hush in anticipation of the night. The attendants transformed your compartment once again, turning back the bedding and leaving a chocolate on the pillow, a sweet note to end the day. The soft clinking of glass and the murmur of voices in the distance were a gentle serenade as you settled in, the landscape now a dark mystery beyond the glass. The train stations you briefly stopped at were like glimpses into different worlds. Some were grand edifices, pillars of marble and glass, where the Orient Express was greeted with the pomp befitting its legendary status. Others were quaint, little more than a platform and a shelter where a solitary lamppost cast a pool of light. Yet, each was a thread in the rich tapestry of the journey, a vignette in the story of your travels. Your fellow passengers were an eclectic mix, a microcosm of the world outside the windows. There were the honeymooners, wrapped up in each other, sharing whispered dreams of the future. There was the solitary writer, his typewriter a constant clatter, as he sought to capture the essence of travel in words. And there was the old couple, who had ridden the train in their youth and now returned to relive the memories, their hands clasped as tightly as they did on their first journey. The Orient Express was more than a train. It was a testament to a bygone era when time was a treasure, not something to be chased. It was a reminder that sometimes the journey is the destination, and the heart can find its contentment in the gentle rocking of a train car, the beauty of the passing world, and the luxury of time unspooling like the tracks that stretch out to the horizon. Night fell like a curtain, and the stars became the jewels in the train's crown. You lay in your bed, the linen soft against your skin, the rhythm of the train a gentle reminder of the miles being conquered as you slept. Dreams mingled with the sound of the wheels, and in that space between waking and slumber, you traveled not just across countries, but through the realms of possibility. The Orient Express, with its whispered promises of adventure, carried you through the night, across the borders of sleep and awakening, and into the heart of dreams. Chapter 2. A Culinary Expedition. The second day aboard the Orient Express dawned with a soft, rosy hue that seeped into your compartment, beckoning you to wake and embrace the new landscape that had unfolded overnight. You obliged, rising to refresh yourself in the compact but ingeniously designed washroom where brass fixtures gleamed and towels were folded with precision. As you dressed, the train curved along a river, its surface mirroring the awakening sky. Breakfast beckoned, and you made your way to the dining car. The tables were set with an array of morning delicacies that appeared almost too beautiful to consume. Yet, the inviting aroma of fresh pastries and coffee promised a delightful start to the day. You chose a seat by the window, greeting your fellow passengers with nods and smiles, a silent camaraderie born of shared experience. The meal was a leisurely affair, with no urge to rush. The journey itself was a luxury, a chance to savor each moment. The conversation at the tables ebbed and flowed like the landscapes outside, sometimes a gentle murmur, sometimes a lively stream, but always with the undercurrent of excitement for the day ahead. Post-breakfast, you retired to the observation car, a glass-walled domain offering panoramic views. Here, the world outside was an ever-changing tapestry. Mountains capped with snow despite the season, valleys lush and verdant, rivers winding like silver threads through the countryside, the Orient Express offered a view of a world that seemed to belong to an older, more majestic time. The observation car also served as a salon of sorts, where intellectuals debated, poets mused, and travelers exchanged stories. You found yourself engaged in a discussion on the golden age of travel, each person adding their perspective, enriching the conversation like the layers of a fine pastry. As the day matured, so did the scenery. You crossed borders with ease, officials boarding briefly to stamp passports, their uniforms adding to the sense of journeying through a living history. Each country's landscape brought its own flavor to the view, the stark beauty of the Swiss Alps, the pastoral charm of the French countryside, the rolling hills of Austria. Lunch was served as the train meandered through a particularly picturesque stretch. The menu was a reflection of the regions you traversed, each dish a tribute to local produce and culinary traditions. The wine list, too, was a carefully curated selection, with vintages that whispered of sun-drenched vineyards and rich, earthy cellars. In the afternoon, you chose solitude, retreating to your compartment to write postcards that attempted to capture the essence of the journey. The act of writing, of pausing to put pen to paper, felt like a sacred ritual, a way to anchor the fleeting moments into something tangible. As dusk approached, the train staff transformed your compartment once again. The efficiency and attention to detail with which they operated were impeccable, ensuring that your private space was ready for the evening's repose. But before surrendering to the night, there was still the matter of dinner. Dinner aboard the Orient Express was not merely a meal, it was an event, a celebration of the day's journey. The attire was formal, and the atmosphere was charged with a festive spirit. The chefs outdid themselves, presenting a feast that dazzled the senses. The flavors were a symphony, each course harmonizing with the next, leading to a crescendo of a dessert that seemed to dance upon the palate. After dinner, the lounge car welcomed those seeking a nightcap. The pianist played tunes that seemed to resonate with the clack of the rails, a soundtrack to the night's gentle roll. Conversations here were softer, more introspective, as passengers reflected on the day's journey and anticipated the morrow. As the evening wore on, the train seemed to embrace the silence of the night, the stars and moon overseeing your passage. In the privacy of your compartment, you settled into the crisp linen, the world outside reduced to a whisper of wind and the rhythmic heartbeat of the train. It was a lullaby of motion and time, a dance of distance and dreams. And as you drifted into sleep, the Orient Express carried you forward, not just through the physical realms, but through the landscapes of the mind and spirit, where every journey is as much an inward exploration as it is an outward adventure. Chapter 3. Nightfall's Repose. The third morning on the Orient Express began with the same precision and elegance that had marked the entire journey. The gentle rays of dawn were just beginning to peek through the edges of your compartment's curtains, casting a warm glow on the polished wood and brass. You stirred from a restful sleep, the rhythm of the train having become a comforting constant in your dreams. You took your time getting ready, the luxury of having no pressing engagements other than to enjoy the ride allowing for a leisurely pace. Dressing in attire that matched the elegance of your surroundings, you stepped out of your compartment to find the train already alive with morning activity. The breakfast in the dining car was a lavish spread of continental and cooked options. You noticed the addition of local specialties, indicative of the regions the train had passed in the night. There was a sense of excitement among the passengers. Today, the Orient Express would make a longer stop at one of the great cities of Europe. It was a chance to stretch one's legs and take in the sights and sounds of a bustling metropolis. You indulged in freshly baked croissants, their flaky layers melting in your mouth, and sipped on robust coffee that seemed to awaken every sense. The dining car's atmosphere buzzed with the anticipation of the day's excursion, conversations peppered with the plans of fellow travelers. The city, when it came into view, was a masterpiece of architecture and history. Grand buildings adorned with intricate facades lined the streets, and the air was filled with a cacophony of city sounds. The Orient Express pulled into the station with stately grace, coming to a rest amidst the hustle and bustle of urban life. Stepping off the train, you felt the immediate contrast between the insular luxury of the Orient Express and the vibrant energy of the city. You joined a group of passengers on a guided tour, wandering through cobbled streets, marveling at monuments that stood as sentinels to history, and meandering through markets that offered a kaleidoscope of scents, colors, and textures. The guide was a wellspring of stories, weaving tales of the city's past with observations that brought the surroundings to vivid life. You learned of emperors and wars, of artists and artisans, and of the city's transformation through the ages. Every street corner seemed to have a narrative, every building a soul. Lunch was an affair that highlighted local cuisine. You dined al fresco, the city's pulse a backdrop to a meal that was both hearty and delicate. There was an understanding that this break from the train's confines was a part of the journey's tapestry, a thread that added depth and color to the overall experience. After several hours of exploration, you returned to the station where the Orient Express awaited, its polished exterior gleaming like a beacon of comfort and familiarity. The staff welcomed you back with the warmth of old friends, and as the train departed, you watched the city recede, a collection of memories now etched in your mind. Back aboard, the afternoon unfolded with a gentle cadence. You attended a lecture in the salon car, where a historian spoke of the Orient Express's legacy, of its place in the annals of travel, and of the many tales that had been born within and around its carriages. Later, as you returned to your compartment, you found the afternoon tea had been served. A selection of teas accompanied by fine china and silverware, and a variety of sandwiches, pastries, and scones awaited. It was a refined ritual that seemed to slow time, inviting you to relish the flavors and the moment. The remainder of the day was spent in quiet contemplation, watching the world transition from the grandeur of the city to the serene beauty of the countryside. The train passed through small towns and villages, each with its own unique charm, its own story that played out in brief glimpses from your window. Dinner was an affair that seemed to encapsulate the entire day's experiences. The menu was a homage to the city you had visited, with dishes inspired by the local fare, executed with the train's signature flair. The dining car was abuzz with conversations about the day's adventures, each tale adding to the collective narrative of the journey. After dinner, the train's social car hosted a pianist whose melodies were a fitting end to the evening. The notes seemed to dance with the rhythm of the train, a harmony that was both comforting and invigorating. As the night deepened, you found yourself in the observation car, gazing at the stars that seemed to keep pace with the train. There was a peace to be found in their silent vigil, a reminder of the vastness of the journey, both in miles and in experiences. Finally, as the train hummed its lullaby, you retreated to your compartment. The day had been a tapestry of moments, each woven with the thread of the Orient Express's timeless elegance. Lying in bed, you felt the train carry you forward, not just across the landscape, but through a story that was as much about the journey as the destination. Tomorrow promised new sights, new encounters, but for now, the comfort of the train was all the adventure you needed. As you drifted to sleep, you realized that the Orient Express was not just a train, but a moving world, complete with its own rhythm, its own pulse, and its own stories waiting to be told. Chapter 4. Morning's Arrival. The fourth day aboard the Orient Express dawned with an air of introspection. The initial excitement of the journey had settled into a warm familiarity, and you found yourself reflecting on the unique blend of experiences that had been carefully curated, much like the diverse passengers who shared the train with you. The day began with a leisurely brunch in the dining car, where the conversation turned to the various reasons that had drawn each traveler to this journey. For some, it was the romance of travel, the lure of the rails that whispered tales of adventure and elegance from a bygone era. For others, it was the need for respite from the clamor of their daily lives, seeking solace in the steady rhythm of the train as it cut across landscapes and borders with effortless grace. As the train wound its way through dramatic gorges and alongside rivers that mirrored the morning sky, you couldn't help but feel a part of something larger than yourself, a moving tapestry of lives and stories, of past and present, all converging in the luxurious carriages of the Orient Express. The train staff, as ever-present as they were unobtrusive, seemed to anticipate every need. Their attention to detail was impeccable, from the polished silverware to the crisp linens that adorned the tables. It was this level of service that imbued the journey with an almost theatrical quality, each meal and interaction playing out with the precision of a well-rehearsed play. As the day progressed, you attended a wine-tasting event in one of the lounge cars. The sommelier, a gentleman with an encyclopedic knowledge of vineyards and vintages, guided you through a selection of wines that were as rich in story as they were in flavor. Each glass told a story of sun-drenched grapes, of skilled artisans, and of the alchemy that turned simple fruit into liquid poetry. The afternoon was yours to do with as you pleased, and you chose to spend it in the library car, surrounded by volumes of literature that spoke of adventure and discovery. You selected a book whose pages were yellowed with time and settled into a leather armchair that seemed to embrace you like an old friend. Outside, the world passed by in a blur of color and light. You were entranced by the changing scenery, from the deep greens of dense forests to the soft golds of fields ripe with grain. Occasionally, the train would pass through a tunnel, and the car would be enveloped in a comforting darkness that made the return to daylight all the more vivid. As evening approached, you returned to your compartment to dress for dinner. There was something about preparing for the evening meal on the train that felt like a ritual, a transition from the casual ease of the day to the refined elegance of the night. Tonight's dinner was a formal affair, and as you entered the dining car, you were struck by the transformation. Crystal chandeliers cast a soft glow over the tables, now dressed in their evening finery of white tablecloths and flickering candles. The passengers had donned their best attire, and the air was filled with a symphony of conversation, laughter, and the clinking of fine china. The meal itself was an ode to the culinary arts, a multi-course masterpiece that showcased the talents of the chef and his team. Each dish was a celebration of flavor and artistry, from the delicate amuse-bouche to the sumptuous dessert that seemed to melt on your tongue. Conversation flowed as freely as the wine, and you found yourself engaged in discussions that ranged from the trivial to the profound. There was a camaraderie that had formed among the passengers, a shared sense of wonder at the journey they were undertaking together. After dinner, The train's social car played host to a small ensemble of musicians who filled the space with the sounds of jazz and blues. The music seemed to encapsulate the spirit of the train, at once timeless and ever-changing. You couldn't resist the urge to dance, and soon you found yourself swaying to the rhythm, lost in the moment and the movement. As the night drew on, you retired to the observation car, where the sky was a canvas of stars, unmarred by the lights of civilization. The tranquility of the space offered a chance for solitude, for contemplation of the journey that was as much an inward exploration as it was a physical voyage. In the quiet of the observation car, you penned a letter home, trying to capture the essence of the experience, the sights, the sounds, the tastes, and the textures. But more than that, you wrote of the feelings that the journey evoked, of the sense of connection to the world and to the history of those who had traveled these rails before you. When you finally returned to your compartment, the train was hushed, save for the soothing sound of the wheels on the tracks. You dressed for bed in silence, reflecting on the day's experiences, each memory a thread in the rich tapestry of the Orient Express. As you slipped beneath the covers, the train continued its relentless march through the night. You were cocooned in luxury, yet it was the simplest pleasure, the comfort of your compartment, the soft murmur of the train, that lulled you into a peaceful sleep. In the darkness, the train carried you forward, not just toward your destination, but through a journey that transcended time and place, a journey where every moment was a destination in itself.